Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand.
You stay with the kids. I'm gonna go take a look.
You know what, you guys, just sit tight, okay?
You see anyone?
There's nobody here.
We're all brand new.
What? Oh, well, hey, someone's coming.
Flag them down, maybe they know something.
There's no one in that car!
Mom? Mom, why'd you let this car go?
We want to turn now to that major recall involving more than 2 million Tesla cars. That's nearly all of the electric vehicles Tesla has sold in the U.S. CBS's Carter Evans tells us how the company intends to fix a problem with the car's autopilot system.
There's almost nothing left of this Tesla after it slammed into a fire truck on a Northern California freeway last February. The driver was killed, and investigators believe autopilot was engaged when it happened. It's one of dozens of deadly crashes since 2016, allegedly involving the technology, and it led to a National Highway Traffic Safety Administration investigation. Tesla owner Susie Maggett hopes the resulting recall leads to safer use of autopilot.
I was driving on the freeway and saw a man with his seat almost fully reclined, feet out the window, and hands like behind his head going about 95 miles an hour.
Nearly every Tesla sold in the U.S. is affected, and over-the-air software update will now enable the cars to give drivers more warnings when they're not paying attention and even suspend the technology if drivers use it incorrectly.
This recall is actually written in blood.
Robert Sumwalt is former chair of the National Transportation Safety Board. He says he spoke to Elon Musk personally during the agency's own investigation into autopilot 6 years ago.
And as the chairman of the NTSB, I'm talking to him about this investigation, and he hung up on me. I think that shows an arrogance within the organization that is leading to safety problems and killing people.
Now, the software fix has already rolled out to some customers. We reached out to Tesla but have not heard back. However, on Monday, the company posted that it believes that cars that use its autopilot system are safer than those without it.
Nora?
Carter, powerful interviews in such important context. Thank you so much.
Shalom. I want to start off by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakakwadash. All blessings, honor, glory, and power will be unto the Heavenly Father, whose name is Yahweh, through His only begotten Son, our Lord and our Savior, whose name is Yahweh Shai. And double honors to the apostles and the elder bishops of Great Millstone, who taught me this truth. And salutations to the elect scattered abroad throughout the four corners of the earth. My name is Amon Gabar, and I'm back with another quick lesson, Lord's edifying, straight to the point. And as you've seen in the intro of this video, it was a scene from Leave the World Behind, which is this probably the third video I'm doing on this like I call it, documentary. And obviously the events and the sequence of events that's taking place only proves that these devils, pretty much, they're mocking. At this point, they're just straight up mocking, which is part of their revelation of the method / predictive programming / truth hidden in plain sight. It's a way of them mocking their victim, and clearly they're just pretty much mocking at this point. They're pretty much mocking. They sitting back getting a kick out of all the so-called conspiracy theorists, so-called, or whatever, like the world will call conspiracy nuts, and all of this and all of that, and just some people ignoring it, some people paying attention. Well, we paying attention to prophecy first and foremost, you know, because everything links up with prophecy. Everything that's happening in the world links up with prophecy one way or another. All right, which is why we go into certain subjects, topics, movies, films, whatever. If it pertains to prophecy, we'll go into it. And that whole film was a very strategic form of predictive programming and revelation of the method, you know. So hey, at this point they just mocking, but hey, who's gonna get the last laugh? Who's gonna get the last laugh? Who is going to get the last laugh? Real quick, let me see if I got it pulled up. Let me go to Psalms, the second chapter. Who's gonna get the last laugh? Psalms chapter 2 and verse 4. It says, "He that sitteth in the heaven shall laugh. The Lord shall have them in derision. He that sitteth in heaven shall laugh." That's the Most High. All right. And His only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai. The Lord, Yahweh Shai, all right, shall have them in derision. Who's that them? These heathens, starting with the Edomites. All right. They're going to be the ones being mocked. The Heavenly Father is going to have them in a trick bag. You know, all that snares and nets that they've been setting up, they're going to fall right up in it, just like the scriptures say. You know, he that diggeth a pit shall fall into it. You know, especially when they dig a pit for the innocent, they're going to fall into that very pit, just like when you read about in the book of Esther. What's this guy's name? Haman. You know, Haman built the gallows to try to get Mordecai lynched, hung, but he ended up being lynched and hung at the end. All right, it came right back on him. So yeah, that's Esau, that's his nation. So he that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh, the Lord shall have them in derision. So who's gonna get the last laugh? You know, Esau is mocking the victim right now and just laughing and getting a kick out of it and just putting it right there in front of everybody's faces. At this point, it's like, what can they do about it? You know, that's their mentality. But the Lord is gonna have you in derision. We can't do nothing about it. We ain't gonna do nothing about it until the Lord raises us up. You know, so this is the clip, this is the scene right here. As you seen, you know, they were driving, they pulled up, they thought people was driving and got out their cars until she realized that it was a malfunction in the Tesla vehicles. It was self-driving, as you see here. Full self-driving capability, navigate on autopilot, automatic driving, auto lane change while driving on highway, auto park both parallel and perpendicular parking, summon your car will find you in a parking lot. That's crazy. But hey, Esau's technology is laughable. It's laughable. Here it is, you know, they recalling it and, you know, got into an accident. You know, you see it right there, you know, and through the spirit. I haven't watched it just yet. You know, recently just put up, Elder Apostle Gabar just put up a video on his page. About 40 minutes low when I watch it later on, but he had just put up a video and he tied it with the prophecy Isaiah 19 and 14. So, you know, go check that video out, you know, just this prophecy rolling forth, coming out. You saw, and you know, their minions is just, they're going hard. They're on overdrive. And you got this guy, Elon Musk. They got the robots I had mentioned in the video live I did last night. What they call it, Tesla 2 or something like that. Like it's like a Tesla robot. What you think them robots is for? All that advanced technology that they got in these robots, they ain't to go flip burgers at Burger King. Them shits is to get strapped and equipped with heavy artillery to be loosed, all right? Loosed in these hoods and ghettos and go against these people that are gonna fight back when these devils come down with that wrath. You know, and that's just some of the reasons they're going to use them for. The military is using them. Police force are going to use them. All of that. You know, so anyway, like I'm saying, through the spirit, this is just more mockery from the elites. This movie came out, I believe it was in theaters November. November 22nd, it was in select theaters. And December 8th is when they put it up on Netflix. All right. And then slowly but surely, you got certain events happening, you know, cyber attacks. Shortly after that movie, well, they've been talking about cyber attacks, but shortly after that, that film documentary came out on Netflix and everybody's seen it. You had China cyber attack. You know, I did a video on that. Last night in New York, New Jersey, Con Ed plant, power plant exploded or something like that. It caught on fire and it was blackouts for a little period of time. And you know, just things is happening, bro. Just things is happening. Things is happening. Everything that the Lord said would happen is happening. All right. And he's using these devils to bring it forth. You know, that his instrument for his works. He's using these devils. So I got a couple more precepts and that's going to conclude the lesson, little one. This is the book of Isaiah 64 in verse 2. It says, "Hide me from the secret counsel of the wicked," which are these the wicked elites of this world, all right, the top international bankers, the Rothschilds, the ones that run this earth. Job 9:24, the earth is given into the hands of the wicked, them guys, them devils, all right? So hide me from the secret counsel of the wicked, you know, that secret, you know, the power was in their secrecy, you know, the power behind the agenda of the New World Order. Less people know, the better it was for them, but the truth had gone out. So that was like a monkey wrench in their plan. That was a disruption in their plan. They ain't think this truth would have went out like that. Like that one Rockefeller dude said, I believe it was a Rockefeller who said the worst thing ever created was the internet, or we should have never created the internet, something along those lines. You know why? Because the Lord put the spirit on them. Like the scriptures say, man's going is of the Lord. How can a man then understand his own ways? All right, the king's hand is in the Lord, and the Lord will turn it whithersoever he will. You know, no free will. The Lord put it in their spirit to do this. For his agenda, to hide pride from men. All right, so the internet was up, the truth went out, the truth sprung forth and just took over. You see, so they ain't think that was gonna happen. So hide me from the secret counsel of the wicked, the evil agenda, the New World Order agenda. Everything we've seen in the movies is all predictive programming, revelation of the method, truth hidden in plain sight, things that will eventually come to pass to an extent. All right, to an extent, because he's not going to reach the fullness of his new world order. Thus save the scriptures. It says from the insurrection of the workers of iniquity, because that's all they do. That's what they do. They work iniquity day and night. This is Micah 2 and 1. Woe to them that devise iniquity and work evil upon their beds. Woe, death, destruction. All right, to them that devise iniquity and work evil upon their beds, when the morning is light, that they practice it, because it is in their power, it is in the power of their hand. And who gave them the power to do that? The Most High. All right, Yahweh Bashem Yahushai gave them the power to do that. They didn't just come up with it and say, I want to do this and let me do that. No, the Most High put it in their hand, in their power, the illusion of having, like they say, the illusion of freedom or the illusion of free will. Most High gave them the power to do so. They're programmed to be wicked. So they're going to do everything in their power to be wicked. So anyway, it says, and they covet fields and take them by violence, and houses and take them away, excuse me. So they oppress a man in his house, even a man in his heritage. And that's what these devils do. Divide, they spoil, they conquer, they steal. The scripture said, a thief cometh not but to steal. When a thief pop up, guess what he's coming to do? Steal. All right? Oppress, kill. And that's that violent man. These Edomites. And I got also, last but not least, Isaiah 29 and 15. Woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from the Lord, which is foolish, because the Most High gave you the thoughts. He gave you the counsel. He gave you the understanding. He did all of it, all of this. Everything that's happening is under the Lord's power, under his power. He's doing all of this. All right? He's in control. All right? So it's foolish to try to seek deep to hide your counsel from the Lord. You ain't hiding it from the Lord, the Most High. You hiding it from the average person. But even then, the average person, the elect ain't the average person. That's number one. And the scriptures say in Amos 3 and 7 that the Most High, he revealed his secrets to the servants, the prophets. So the secret counsel that Esau has been seeking deep to hide from the Lord, allegedly, right? Supposedly, the Lord gave us the inside scoop. He gave us the heads up on what this man is doing. That's why we're able to tie in videos and movies and articles and things of that nature and tie it in with prophecy, tie it in with scripture, all right? Tie it in with things that are happening. That's why we're able to do that, because we see the bigger picture, all right? We see the bigger picture of things that are going on, the broader picture, we see it. And that's through the Holy Spirit. So it says, I read again, woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from the Lord, and their works are in the dark. And they say, who seeth us and who knoweth us? The Lord sees you. All right, the Most High sees you. Yahweh Shah sees you. The angels see you. All right, and through the Spirit, we see you, because we got the eye salve to see you and see the wickedness that you're doing, talking to these wicked elites. All right, the Most High is revealing you. You know, so, you know, at this point, like I said in the title, if I keep that title after this is published and uploaded, at this point, they're just mocking. They're just mocking their victims. They're just mocking people. You know, they probably getting a kick out of all the videos and but whatever. It is what it is. All right? It is what it is. Only the simple is going to pass on by. You know, like the scripture said, a wise man foresee the evil and hide himself, but the simple passes by. All right? To the simple, they just going to say, oh, it's just a movie. It's just this, or it's just that, or it's just coincidence, or they just did that. So, with all this happening, and with more information, and all the hidden truth that they put in this movie, at this point, there's no lie. What lie is in there in that movie? At this point, everything that they put out there in that documentary, that film, at this point, from my recollection, you know, in my mind, from what I've seen, everything seems factual and plausible. Like, it's going to happen, you know? Things are all going to happen. Blackouts, you know, grid attacks, EMP attacks. And let's not forget, that was only taking place in the suburbs. I mean, the film I'm talking about, they only shot what was going on in the suburbs. How about the city? So all hell was already breaking loose in the city. So Esau using this film to mock, you know, his victims, then the greater, more devastating part of this movie that we didn't see, which is civil unrest in the city, all that's about to happen. All that's getting ready to happen. All right, martial law is getting ready to be declared. You know, they got this movie coming out called Civil War, which ain't nothing but another documentary. And they showing you what's going to happen. I uploaded it to Amon Gabar page. You know, my other page, I uploaded it there. So, you know, they just telling you, bro. They're just telling you things. You know, hey, that's that pride too. That's that pride. You know, they boast of their heart's desire. That's that pride also. Because at this point, they saying, who could stop us? Like, you know, we going to put it out there, and what are the people going to do? But that's why scripture say the Most High is going to laugh and have you in derision. So, you know, that's pretty much it. You know, that's all I wanted to really speak on this particular thing. You know, another part to that, to the film I've been speaking on lately, which is a good watch, a very good watch, and everybody should have seen it by now. So, Lord willing, this was quick, edifying, straight to the point. Till next time, shalom to the elect. Shalom.